that is one delicious sauce. To foodies like me, there are a few things in life that are more exciting than the sweet, scrumptious sounds we make in the kitchen. When you hear the thump, thump, thump on the counter, the crunch of vegetables on the chopping board, the blitz of appliances, that first sizzle in the frying pan, the ding of the timer going off, and the unmistakable sounds of satisfaction, and you just know something good is coming your way.
So, so good.
Today on Casa Daza Summer, we make sweet, delicious music with two classic French dishes that hit all the right notes. The light and silky French quiche and the deep, robust coq au vin.
Bon appétit. This is so delicious.
So listen up, my foodie friends, because these two recipes will have you saying ooh la la in no time.
In this episode, we're going French all the way. Our very first recipe is we're going to make a classic quiche. What is quiche? Quiche is a pie, but it's a savory pie. It's a complete meal. You have vegetables, you have protein, you have carbs, right?
The French quiche, a timeless classic, is an elegant and easy all-in-one meal. It is basically a milk and egg custard baked into a savory pie crust, made exciting with the endless list of fillings you can put into it. Mushroom, salmon, asparagus, bacon, you name it, you can make a quiche with it.
You may put shrimps, you may put ham and egg. You use your imagination. You can use chicken if you wish, or any kind of filling that you can imagine you could do. In this particular quiche, we're just going to make some spinach, and flavored cheeses, and of course egg, which is standard ingredient.
The first step to this delectable baking project, start preheating the oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit.
We're going to make a pie crust first. Okay, well, that's going to be quite easy, but what I've done is I've added a little touch of my own to make it a little bit more flavorful.
A savory pastry dough is as simple as putting together flour, salt, water, and butter. My extra special touch to our pie crust, grated Parmesan cheese. Boom! Non-bakers might have to go out and buy their first serrated pie pan. But the other tools you will need are probably already in your kitchen as we speak. A food processor, a fork, a pair of kitchen scissors, some wax paper and plastic wrap, a rolling pin, and about 2 cups of uncooked rice.
Trust me, you will enjoy making this. Let's start.
In the food processor, dump in the flour, salt, Parmesan cheese, and butter. Pulse until it looks like breadcrumbs. Then slowly add water until the whole thing turns into a ball of soft dough. If you want a fabulous flaky crust, wrap the dough in plastic and chill it in the ref for at least 30 minutes. Roll out the dough until it's about an inch larger than the size of your pie pan all around. Unroll it over the pie pan and press the pastry into the edges of the pan, patching up edges and trimming off the excess pastry if needed. One thing we want to avoid is the pie crust puffing up during baking. Now there are two ways to do this. One is to create tiny holes that will allow steam to escape during baking. Another is to literally weigh it down with uncooked rice on wax paper. Galing, di ba? Of course, you won't be able to eat the rice anymore after baking. But who wants to eat rice when quiche is on the menu? Bake the pie crust for 15 to 20 minutes or just until the edges start to turn golden brown. You may be wondering, why bake the pie crust now when you're just going to bake it again later with the filling? The reason is a very wet filling like egg custard can make uncooked pastry dough soggy. Baked crusts will stay firm long enough for the filling to set in the oven.
Okay, now we've pre-cooked the crust. Okay, it is the pie crust of our quiche. Look at that. You can either use uncooked beans or uncooked rice. Okay, so we take this out. Okay, so there's a little doneness to the crust. Make sure you remove any excess rice, if there are any. Now, we start making the filling.
A lot of French dishes rely on thick-cut bacon for flavor, and this tasty quiche is no exception. The classic quiche Florentine is made with a silky egg and cream custard packed with spinach, white wine, olive oil, garlic, red and yellow onions, butter, and nutmeg. Plot twist, instead of using just one kind of cheese like the classic recipes, I'm using three. Mellow Gruyere and Emmental will give this quiche a gooey consistency, while the loud flavors of Gorgonzola will definitely add a welcome bite. Yum!
Okay, we start making the filling of our quiche by melting some butter. Okay. And a lot of flavor in that butter, but remember, butter burns easily, so we're going to add some olive oil. You might be wondering why I'm using a grill in an open air setting like this one. Beautiful scenery, we're beside the beach, but there's also wind. It's gonna be kind of difficult to cook on a burner because what happens is the fire doesn't shoot up because it's blown away by the wind. So we adjust. Don't stop yourself and say, no, I can't cook it anymore. You adjust. Use your imagination. So now, so I've added the garlic, onions, butter, and olive oil. I'm gonna add some bacon for flavoring. Okay, this will take a while because I'm going to extract the fat from the bacon. Oh, here we go. Okay, what we can then do is add some white wine. Maybe about 1/3 cup of white wine. Then we add in our spinach and cook this until it's wilted. Okay. Okay, so what we're going to do here is wait for the spinach to become wilted, and then we're going to drain the liquid. Now, we're going to cool that a little bit, and then me personally, I like to chop the spinach because I don't like to bite into a spinach and, you know, it's so long. So I like to have my spinach with all the flavor, but yet not so chewy.
Just a rattle and hum. A snip snip. A glug glug. A sizzle sizzle, and our French quiche is already off to a lively start. Now it's time for this dish to go out with a bang.
Okay, we're going to make the other part of the filling. We have 4 eggs. Okay, 4 whole eggs.
2, 3.
Okay. And then we add in some cream, maybe about a cup of nice thick cream. I have some fresh grated nutmeg. You know, the taste of this is so strong, so you don't really need much. About 1/4 teaspoon lang.
Nutmeg has such an enticing flavor and scent, especially when it's freshly grated. But in a pinch, pre-ground nutmeg will also do a good job in this recipe.
I can smell the aroma of nutmeg. We season this with a little salt and pepper. Normally what you do is this one is the one that's going to bind everything together. But what I like to do here is that I want to add a little mixture of the Gruyere and the Emmental. Okay, just a little. Okay, now this one will add a little stickiness to the mixture.
Whisk to send pockets of gooey cheese all throughout the egg mixture, and you're all set for the next step.
First thing we did, we pre-baked the crust, okay? Then we made the spinach. Then we made the egg mixture, okay? Now assembly. This is the way we assemble this. We get the spinach, which we've drained. By the way, you keep that oil because that's loaded with a lot of flavors, okay? Then we spread this out, spinach all over, okay? What we will do is we will put this cheese, Emmental and Gruyere, which are gooey, sticky cheese, yung mozzarella type. Okay, you spread it all over. Remember, I put some in the egg and cream mixture already. Now, at this point, if you just leave it like this, the cheese could be very, very subtle yung flavor. But what I want to do is add a little stronger cheese by putting some crumbled gorgonzola all over. Okay, any kind of cheese will do, no? If you have blue cheese, you can put also some feta cheese if you like. I like to put a little stronger cheese.
I know it's very tempting, but try not to overdo it with the blue cheese because the sharp bite could easily eclipse the other flavors.
And then what we will do finally is to add in the egg cream sauce. Those of you out there who are curious foodies, can you imagine the taste of this? Now, I have a preheated oven, 350 degrees, and we are going to bake this for about 25, 30 minutes. You will see naman the top, eh, no? So, we're just going to wait for the eggs to settle or to set, and that's done.
And that, my hungry friends, is the sound of success. Don't forget to let this cool down for about 15 minutes before digging in. Say bonjour to our 4-cheese, 5-star French quiche. You're gonna love this.
Okay, tasting time. Look at that. That's a beautifully made quiche. Now, what I'm looking for here is the balance of the carbs or the starch and the filling. Oh my God, that is so good. You can taste the bacon, or I can taste the nutmeg and the aroma of the nutmeg and the cheese. This is so, so good. Mmm.
Mild meets wild and our fillings cheesy trifecta. The smooth Swiss cheese base is the perfect canvas for the sharpness of the Italian gorgonzola. Cheese lovers out there, this dish will make all your fromage fantasies come true. As for the crust, you'll be glad you pre-baked it because the subtle crunch offsets the incredible softness of that filling.
Alam mo, the thickness of the crust balances the filling. You know that the ratio of carbs and, you know, and filling. Sarap, very nice balance. The taste is so good. You have to try this.
Savory, silky, gooey, chewy, and crunchy. Now that is what I call a complete meal.
Très, très bon.
We're making quite a racket in the Casa Daza kitchen today, all in the name of good food. And this indulgent episode is going out with a loud bang, courtesy of another classic French recipe that makes all the right noises.
Our next dish is a dish that they call coq au vin, or chicken in red wine. This is a very typical French dish, which is considered like a traditional French dish. No, now you go to any home, everybody knows how to make this coq au vin. It's usually had with baguette, French baguette, and you have a glass of wine or something. You can have it with red wine, of course, but it's really up to you. To me, this is one of my favorite French dishes. I'm going to show you how to make this. It's actually very, very simple.
Traditionally, coq au vin is made using a whole cut-up coq, literally a rooster, and lardon, or sticks of salted pork belly. Today, we will simply use cuit de poulet and bacon. The rest of the ingredients are almost the same as what we used in our beef bourguignon back in season 1. Farine, champignon, ay, celery, carrot, onion, echalot, vin rouge, bouillon de poulet, thyme, and of course, the secret to the decadence of French food, beurre. Use lots of it.
The way we start this is I have some flour. What we will do is we will just dredge the chicken. I've chosen to use the cut na chicken thigh, no? And the reason I like that is I prefer dark meat. Okay, so you just cover that in flour.
Flour is a nifty little shortcut I use for two reasons. One, it will help crisp up the skin while we brown our chicken quickly over high heat. And two, the flour left in the oil will help thicken our red wine sauce later on.
Okay, it's nice and brown. This is not done at all, okay? So the insides are gonna be raw. You don't really have to cook the chicken fully. We're just putting some texture to it, okay? And then what we do, you know, you can either drain some of the oil if you want, or just add in the bacon. Wow, look at this.
After rendering the bacon and setting it aside, we use that same flavorful oil to saute our aromatics.
Okay, what we will then do is add the other ingredients like our chicken stock. We'll add our mushrooms. Okay. Sayang yan. We add our shallots. Okay. We're going to add some thyme, maybe about a teaspoon of thyme. That'll add a little aroma that's kind of different. Okay. And then we add in our chicken one by one.
Sayang yung oil.
We add in our bacon. Wow, look at that. Then we're gonna add in our red wine. Maybe about 2 cups of red wine, more if you want.
Any inexpensive bottle of red will work with this recipe, but if you want to be as authentic as possible, use a red burgundy wine like Pinot Noir. We cover and simmer a kokovan for 30 to 40 minutes. Then uncover and let it bubble enthusiastically for another 15 minutes until we get a thick, deeply flavorful stew.
Wow, look at that. Oh, this is so, so delicious. Now, just a touch of butter.
And by a touch, I mean something like 1/4 cup of butter. Sorry, not sorry.
You can smell the evaporated aroma of the red wine. Okay, now if that appeals to you, then this is a perfect dish for you. Okay.
And voila! Rustic, robust kokovan, bursting with incredible flavor, aroma, and texture. Serve with baguette for an authentic French touch.
Mmm. I like just the crust of the baguette. Mmm. You know, I've simmered that chicken long enough, even the skin melts. Oh, wow. The sauce reduced, it became thicker, the vegetables started to melt, but all the flavors are intact. You come up with one unique, robust taste. Sarap! Mmm! C'est très, très bon.
Trust me, this dish will blow you away. But of course, the only way to find out is by cooking it yourself. I hope you can give this recipe a try. Happy cooking and bon appetit!
Now that is one delicious sauce.